Hello friends, you are welcome to our literary channel Academic Domain. Today I am going to discuss UGC NET exam paper 3, which was conducted in June 2012, and there were 25 questions in that paper. And friends, if you are new to my channel and haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe it and press the bell icon to get notified my new videos. Like, share and give your valuable feedback so that I can do better in my next videos. So the question number 1, in Ben Jonson's Walpole, the animal imagery includes, the right answer is D, that is A and C are correct. So A is the fox and the vulture, and the C is the fly, the crow and the raven. So the correct answer will be D. Question number 2. Salman Rushdie's imaginary homeland is dash. So here the correct answer is B, an essay that propounds an anti-essentialist view of place. Question number 3. Identify the correct statement below. So here are 4 statements A, B, C, D, and we have 4 options A, B, C, D. So the correct answer will be B. It means in B we have B and D. So let's see what is there in B and D. B, expanded basic read, broadly ascertained scientific international course. And D, while keeping to normal constructions, basic failed as an experiment because its documents were far too complicated and technical to understand. So here the correct answer will be B. Question number 4. Items in a published book appear in the following order. So here the correct answer is C. So we will see the first will be copyright page, second will be footnotes, third will be bibliography, and the last will be index. Question number 5. Match the following. So here we have the group of the writers and then the school to which they belong. For example, in the first group we have James Thomson, Oliver Goldsmith, William Cowper, George Crabbe, and in the same way we have 4 groups of writers here, and then we have schools to which they belong. So here in this answer, in this question, the right answer is C. So C means the first group belongs to that B is transitional poets. The second group belongs to A is metaphysical poets. The third group belongs to C, that is war poets. And the fourth group belongs to D, that is Georgians. Question number 6 now. The following phrases from Shakespeare have become the titles of famous works. Identify the correctly matched group. Here, these phrases have been taken from Shakespeare's works, and now these phrases became the title of the works by these writers. So here we see the correct answer is C. It means that the first one, The Pale Fire, is written by Vladimir Nabokov, and the second one, The Sound and the Fury, was written by C, that is William Faulkner, and the third one, Rosencrantz and Guildenstern are Dead, written by, that is D, Tom Stoppard, and the fourth one, Under the Greenwood Tree, written by A, that is Thomas Hardy, and the fifth one, Of Cakes and Ale, written by B, that is Somerset Maugham. Question number 7. Identify the statement that is not true among those that explain stage directions in drama. So here the right answer is C. That is, stage directions are often italicized in the text of a play in order to be spoken aloud. Question number 8. The emergence of the concept of world literature is associated with. The correct answer is C. In C we have B and C. So B, John Wolfgang von Goethe, and the C is Johann Gottfried Herder. Question number 9. Gunter Grass Tindrum is part of a trilogy known as the Dancing Trilogy. So here the correct answer is C. That is, Cat and Mouse and Dog Ears. Question number 10. The hostess proudly announces that the family can afford a servant and her daughters have nothing to do with the kitchen. Who is the proud mother in this Jane Austen novel? So, the correct answer is C, that is Mrs. Bennet. Question number 10. When Keats writes about the beaker full of the blushful Hippocrene, Hippocrene is. The correct answer is D. In D we have A and B. It means that A, the fountain of the horse, and B, a spring sacred to the muses. Question number 12. Which of the following statements on the prelude by Wordsworth, William Wordsworth, is or not true? So here the correct answer is C. C is not true. So what is C? The poem runs to 14 books. At crucial stages, the poet celebrates the sublime natural scenery in developing his spiritual, moral, and imaginative nature. Question number 13. Assertion, that is A. At the end of Heart of Darkness, Marlowe tells a lie to the intended about Kurtz when he tells her the last word he pronounced was your name. The reason, or Marlowe tells this lie because he is secretly in love with the intended and tells her what she wants to hear. So here we have four options. The correct answer will be B. So in B, that is, A and R are truth, both A and R are true, but R is not the correct explanation. Question number 14. Ear training in ELT is easily achieved by. The correct answer is D. So in D we have B and D. So B, that is dictation, D we have listening exercises. So the correct answer will be D here. Question number 15. William Shakespeare's Julius Caesar, Antony and Cleopatra, and Coriolanus are based on. The correct answer is D, that is Plutarch's Lives. Question number 16. The basic concept that creation was ordered, that every species exists in a hierarchy of status from God to the lowest creature, was prevalent in the Renaissance. In this hierarchical continuum, man occupies the middle position between the animal kinds and the angels. So here the correct answer is C. See, the great chain of being. Question number 17. In Virginia Woolf's To the Lighthouse, the lighthouse does not symbolize. The correct answer is B. Change in the unchanging world. So question number 18. So it is a little lengthy paragraph, and you please pause the video and read it once, and I will tell only the answer, that is answer D. Answer D is, this is George Orwell on Rudyard Kipling. Question number 19. In the well-known poem To His Coy Mistress, the word coy means. So we have four options like shy, timid, voluptuous, sensuous. So the correct answer is A, that is shy. Question number 20. From the following list, आइडेंटिफाई बैग फॉर्मेशन, सल, बल्क, स्टॉक, पोक, स्विंडल, बंडल. सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज डी, दैट इज बल्क, पोक, बंडल. क्वेश्चन नंबर 21. इट ब्लर्स डिस्टिंक्शंस अमंग लिटरेरी, नॉन लिटरेरी एंड कल्चरल टेक्स्ट, शोइंग हाउ ऑल थ्री इंटर सर्कुलेट, शेयर इन एंड म्यूचुअली कंस्टिट्यूट ईच अदर. What does it in this statement stand for? So here the question is about this it, that what does it mean here. So the correct answer is D, that is new historicism. Question number 22. For though I have no idea what this accoutred frowsty dash is worth, it pleases me to stand in silence here. Fill in the blank. So here we have four options. The right answer will be B. Question number 23. Which of the following novels is not a partition novel? Like Azadi, Tamas, Clear Light of the Day, That Long Silence. So the correct answer is That Long Silence. It's not a partition novel. Question number 24. Of the following characters, which one does not belong to a house for Mr. Biswas? The correct answer is Ralph Singh. Question number 25. In English literature, the trope of the vampire was used for the first time by, question answer is C, that is John Steig. Question number 26. Why is universal grammar so called? The correct answer is B, it is a set of basic grammatical principles assumed to be fundamental to all natural languages. Question number 27. Identify the novel with the wrong subtitle listed below. So here the correct answer is D, that is Felix Holt, the Socialist. Question number 28. Match list 1 with list 2. Here we have list 1 and here we have list 2. So in one list 1, in one we have the writer and then other one we have the works. So the correct answer will be C here. It means that the first one, like David Morloff, it will match with the B, that is Wildcat Falling, and the second one, that is Patrick White, and the Patrick White wrote the C, that is Remembering Babylon, and the third one, Peter Carey wrote the first one, that is the Solid Mandala, and the fourth one, that is Colin Johnson, he wrote that D, the True History of Kelly Gang. So the correct answer will be C here. Question number 29. The opening sentence of Tolstoy's Anna Karenina, happy families are all alike, every unhappy family is unhappy in its own way. The specific cause of the unhappiness in Oblonsky's house was the husband's affair with. Here the correct answer is C, that is a French governess. Now the question number 30. This periodical had the odd intention to enliven morality with wit and to temper wit with morality, to bring philosophy out of the closets and libraries, schools and colleges, to dwell in clubs and assemblies, at tea tables and coffee houses. It also promoted family, marriage and courtesy. So the periodical under reference is, the correct answer is The Spectator. Question number 31. Here we have assertion and reason. So Time or Center by John Clare is about the experience of an ordinary human being and became quite popular during that time. द रीजन इज जॉन क्लेयर हैविंग सफर्ड बाउट्स ऑफ मैडनेस कुड रियली फील फॉर द मिजरी ऑफ कॉमन मैन इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ द टू स्टेटमेंट्स विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज करेक्ट. सो हियर द करेक्ट आंसर इज बी दैट इज बोथ ए एंड आर बोथ आर ट्रू बट आर डज नॉट एक्सप्लेन ए. क्वेश्चन नंबर 32. अलेक्जेंडर पोप्स एन एसे इन क्रिटिसिज्म. सो द राइट आंसर इज डी हियर दैट इज ओनली ए एंड डी आर करेक्ट. सो व्हाट इज ए दैट परपोज टू डिफाइन विट एंड नेचर एज दे अप्लाई टू द लिटरेचर ऑफ हिज एज एंड द डी इज अपीयर्ड इन 1701. So here that A and D both are correct. So the answer will be D here. Question number 33. What is register? So the correct answer will be C. A variety of language used in social situations or one specially designed for the subject it deals with. Question number 34. Jeremy Collier's short view of the immorality and profaneness of the English stage 1698 attacked. The correct answer is C, that is the coarseness and ugliness of Restoration Theatre. Question number 35. One of the most important themes the speakers debate in Dryden's an essay on dramatic poesy is. The correct answer is C, that is the relative merits of French and English theatre. Question number 36. Identify the correctly matched pair. So here the correct answer will be D, the Salman Rushdie, the Enchantress of Florence. Question number 37. Match the following correctly. So here we have the term or the concept, and here we have the writers to which these terms are associated. So the correct answer will be B here. It means that the first one, Lang and Perrault, is associated with Ferdinand de Saussure, and the second one, that is competence and performance, is associated with Noam Chomsky. The third one, iconic indexical, associated with C.S. Pierce, and the last one, readerly, writerly, associated with Roland Barthes. Now, question number 38. So here, now we have two groups. This is the one group, and this is the another group. So we have to match here. So the correct answer will be C. So in C, that is the first one matches with the gunny sack. The first one matches with the Obasan Vasanji, and the second one with the gunny sack, and the third one with disappearing Itwaru moon cake, and the last one, the fourth one, with bloody rites. Question number 39. Why does Jane Baudrillard adopt Disneyland as his own sign? So here the correct answer is C, that is Disneyland is an artifact that so obviously announces its own fictiveness that it would seem to imply some counterbalancing reality. Question number 40. Which of the following statements is not true of Dante Gabriel Rossetti? So here the correct answer is C. He married Christina Georgina, who was a poet in her right. So question number 41. Goethe's Faust part 1 scene 1 opens in. The correct answer is Faust's study. क्वेश्चन नंबर 42, इज इट दे आर सिंगल माइंड साइज्ड स्कल्स आर अ ट्रेंड बॉडी आर जीनियस आर अ नेस्ट फुल ऑफ ब्रेड्स गिव्स देयर डेज दिस बुलेट एंड ऑटोमेटिक पर्पस इन ब्रैकेट थ्रशेस इन द अबव लाइंस व्हाट डज देयर रिफर टू एंड व्हाट क्वालिटी ऑफ देयर डज द पोएट स्पीक ऑफ हियर द करेक्ट आंसर इज डी दैट इज वन एंड दैट इज टू एंड थ्री आर करेक्ट सो टू द थ्रशेस एंड देयर कंसेंट्रेशन इन अचीविंग व्हाट दे सेट आउट फॉर एंड द थर्ड वन द इफिशियंसी ऑफ द थ्रशेस इन गेटिंग एट देयर प्रे क्वेश्चन नंबर 43 फाइंड द ऑड वुमन आर मैन आउट सो हियर द करेक्ट आंसर इज डी दैट इज द रूइन द बाइबल क्वेश्चन नंबर 44 विल्की कॉलिंस नॉवेल द मूनस्टोन विच वॉज पब्लिश्ड इन 1868 टेल्स द स्टोरी ऑफ द करेक्ट आंसर इज सी अ फेबुलस येलो डायमंड स्टोलन फ्रॉम एन इंडियन श्राइन क्वेश्चन नंबर 45 आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्टली मैच्ड ग्रुप सो हियर द फर्स्ट ग्रुप इज द टाइटल ऑफ द पोएम आर द लाइन फ्रॉम द पोएम एंड दिस ग्रुप इज द राइटर्स आर द पोएट्स हु कंपोज दिस पोएम्स आर द लाइन्स सो हियर द करेक्ट आंसर विल बी बी दैट इज इन द फर्स्ट पोएम बिकॉज आई कुड नॉट स्टॉप फॉर डेथ is by Emily Dickinson and the second one oh captain my captain is by William Walt Whitman and the third one two roads diverged in a wood is by Robert Frost and the fourth one so much depends upon that is William Carlos Williams question number 46 now stop your noses readers All and some, for here is a ton of midnight work to come. Og from a treason tavern rolling home, round as a globe and liquored every chink, goodly and great, he rails behind his link. In the above passage from Absalom and Achitophel, link means the correct answer is B, a hired servant who carries a lighted torch. Question number 47. Which among the following is not a typical Indian English poem by Nisim Ezekiel? So the correct answer is A. How the English Lessons Ended. Question number 48. Match the following. So here we have the pen names and here we have the real names. So the correct answer will be B. It means that the pen name of the George Orwell is the pen name of Mary Ann Evans. Saki is the pen name of H.H. Munro. And Emily Bronte is the pen name of Alice Bell. And Mark Twain is the pen name of Samuel Langhorne Clemens. So question number 49. In Canto 17 of the Inferno, the monster Graham represents A. The correct answer is A. That is a fraud. Question number 50. I. Richard's famous experiment with poems and his Cambridge students is detailed in Practical Criticism, a study of literary judgment, which was published in 1929. Richard's was astonished by the correct answer is A. The poor quality of his students. Stock responses. Question number 51. Based on the following descriptions, identify the text in reference. So, please read this text and I will tell you the answer. The correct answer is B, that is Waiting for Godot. That this is written about the play Waiting for Godot. Question number 52. One of the following Canterbury Tales is in prose. Identify. So the correct answer is here, The Parson's Tale. So these other tales are in verse. This only B one is in prose. Question number 53. In the distinction between imagination and fancy, Coleridge identifies the following. So here the correct answer is C. It means that B and C for fancy, A and D for imagination. So B and C for fancy. What is that? It has aggregative and associative power. It plays with fixities and definites. So it was about the fancy, and then A and D for imagination. A, that is, it dissolves, diffuses, dissipates in order to recreate, and it has shaping and modifying power. So the correct answer will be C here. Question number 54. Julia Kristeva's intertextuality derives from. So that is Saussure's sign, Chomsky's deep structure, Bakhtin dialogism, Derrida's difference. So the correct answer is B, that is A and C. Question number 55. Ralph Ellison enjoys subverting myths about white purity through characters like Norton, Bledsoe, Reinhardt, all of the above. The correct answer is A, that is A and B. Question number 56. Which of the following is not true of Ralph Waldo Emerson? The correct answer is A. He wrote essays on New England scenery, woodcraft and plantations. Question number 57. Exorcism is the title of Act 3 of Who is Afraid of Virginia Woolf? What is the significance of exorcism in the context of the play? So the correct answer is D. Exposing all attempts, all illusion making. Question number 58. Womanist is not feminist as purple is to lavender. This is an important statement defining the womanist perspective advanced by. The correct answer is C. Alice Walker. Question number 59. Identify the mismatched pair in the following where characters in Golding's Lord of the Flies fit the allegorized pattern of virtues and vices. The correct answer is C, that is Jack Pitty. Question number 60. A subaltern perspective is one where. The correct answer is B. The politically disposed could be voiceless, written out of the historical record and ignored because their activities do not count for cultural or structured. Question number 61. A interlanguage is a term V-O-T-M-A-K Halliday. So here the correct answer is C, that is A and C are correct. So A, interlanguage develops an autonomous and self-contained grammatical system, and C, it is a distinct stage in a learner's progress in the study of a second language. So here the correct answer will be C. 62. In a classic statement that inaugurated feminist thought in English, we read, a woman writing things back through her mothers. Where does this occur? So the correct answer is A, that is Virginia Woolf's A Woman, A Room of One's Own. Question number 63. Identify the correctly matched pair of translators and translations. So these are the translators and these are the translations. So the correct answer is A here. In A, we see that the A.K. Ramanujan translated Speaking of Shiva, and then मथनाथ दत्त ट्रांसलेटेड द महाभारत एंड देन मोहिनी चैटर्जी ट्रांसलेटेड द भगवद गीता एंड देन रोमेश चंद्र दत्त ट्रांसलेटेड द रामायण। क्वेश्चन नंबर 64, असर्शन ए, इन द पावर एंड द ग्लोरी ग्रीन शोज हाउ द विस्की प्रीस्ट ट्रांसेंड्स हिज वीकनेस फॉर ड्रिंक एंड हिज ह्यूमन फियर्स मूविंग टुवर्ड्स मार्टर्डम। रीजन, ट्रांसेंडेंस इन ग्रीन्स नॉवेल्स इज जनरली एन आउटकम ऑफ लव फॉर ह्यूमैनिटी बट प्राइड इज ऑल्सो एन एसेंशियल इन्ग्रीडियंट इन द प्रीस्ट्स कैरेक्टर। सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज सी। इन सी बोथ ए एंड आर ट्रू बट आर इज नॉट द करेक्ट एक्सप्लेनेशन फॉर ए। क्वेश्चन नंबर 65, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स ऑन जॉन ड्राइडन इज इनकरेक्ट। सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज सी। सी इज इनकरेक्ट। सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इज सी। ड्राइडन रोट अ प्ले ऑन द मुगल एम्परर हुमायूं। दैट इज इनकरेक्ट। क्वेश्चन नंबर 66, सो प्लीज पॉज द वीडियो एंड रीड द पैराग्राफ एंड देन रीड द ऑप्शंस हियर एंड आई विल टेल यू द आंसर ओनली। दैट इज बी। इट मीन दैट ए एंड सी आर करेक्ट। सो दिस ए एंड सी बोथ आर करेक्ट। सो प्लीज पॉज द वीडियो फॉर अ मिनट एंड रीड दिस पैराग्राफ केयरफुली। क्वेश्चन नंबर 67, द वर्ल्ड डोमिनेटेड बाय कोल्ड एंड हिपोक्रिटिकल मटेरियलिस्ट्स इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय विलियम ब्लेक इन द मिथोलॉजिकल फिगर ऑफ। द करेक्ट आंसर इज ए ओरिजेन। क्वेश्चन नंबर 68, आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्टली मैच्ड ग्रुप। सो दीज आर द ग्रुप्स वन A, B, C and D. So please pause the video and read it. So I will tell the correct answer. The correct answer is C. That is C. Question number 69. Which of the following can be best described as? So the first one is the first statement of Bernard Shaw's idea of life force. Two, a play dealing with a woman's pursuit of her mate. And three, a play whose third act called Don John in Hell is both unconventional and hilarious. So the correct answer is B here, Man and Superman. Question number 70, identify the untrue statement on the contact zone below. So please read these options once and pause the video. So I will tell only the correct answer. The correct answer is D. That is, it is believed that the contact zone was largely instrumental in spearheading nationalist movements across the world. So question number 71, name the novel in which one, the protagonist is a war veteran called Tayo. Two, Tayo returns from World War II thoroughly disillusioned and haunted by his violent actions of wartime. Three, Tayo seeks consolation and counsel from old Betoni. And four, the protagonist realizes the importance of harmonizing humanity and the universe. So here the correct answer is B, ceremony. Question number 72, one of the following poems in Men and Women is addressed to Elizabeth Barrett Browning by the poet. Identify it. The correct answer is D, One Word More. Question number 73, match list 1 with list 2 according to the quotes given below. So the list 1 we have Tennessee Williams, Eugene O'Neill, Lauren Hansberry and Arthur Miller. And here we have their works, Emperor Jones, The Streetcar Named Desire, The थर्ड वन इज आफ्टर द फॉल एंड द फोर्थ वन इज अरेजिन इन द सन. सो वी हैव टू मैच हियर दैट विच विच वर्क्स इज रिटन बाय विच राइटर. सो हियर द करेक्ट आंसर विल बी डी. इट मीन्स दैट टेनेसी विलियम्स रोट अ स्ट्रीट कॉर नेम डिजायर, यूजीन ओनील रोट द एम्परर जॉन्स, लॉरेन हेंसबरी रोट द अरेजिन इन द सन एंड आर्थर मिलर आफ्टर द फॉल. क्वेश्चन नंबर 74 here, मैच द करेक्ट पेयर. सो हियर इन द फर्स्ट लिस्ट वी हैव द थिएटर ऑफ क्रुएल्टी, थिएटर ऑफ द ऑपरेस्ट, एक्सप्रेशनिस्ट थिएटर, एजिट प्रॉप. इन द सेकेंड लिस्ट वी हैव सफदर हाशमी, जॉर्ज कैसर, जर्जी ग्रोटोस्की एंड अगस्टो बाल. सो द करेक्ट आंसर हियर द ऑप्शंस विच वर गिवन बाई यू जी सी इज इनकरेक्ट. सो दैट्स वाई द मार्क्स वॉज अलॉटेड टू ऑल द कैंडिडेट्स. क्वेश्चन नंबर 75 बर्टोल्ट ब्रेख्ट्स एपिक थिएटर. ए टर्न्स द स्पेक्टेटर इनटू एन ऑब्जर्वर, बी वियर्स डाउन द स्पेक्टेटर्स कैपेसिटी फॉर एक्शन, सी रिलाइज ऑन आर्गुमेंट, डी प्रेजेंट्स मैन एज अ प्रोसेस. हियर द करेक्ट आंसर इज बी, दैट इज ए सी एंड डी आर करेक्ट एंड बी इज रॉन्ग.